Drum for the Song podcast.
Yeah, I'm truly grateful for what we did in the early days of Bullet. I had loads of goals, but I kept taking them off, so I had to get new goals for myself. The first one was play with Metallica.
That's incredible. Yeah.
Did you
support them like on a tour, or was it like a show or what?
Yeah, we did 4 shows with them.
Wow.
It was like the biggest thing I've ever seen in my life. It was their own show.
Festival. Yeah. Wow.
Like 100,000 people there.
Was that fairly on in your band's career, or was it later on?
Yeah, it was our first album, Poison.
Wow. Wow. Yeah. Well, I guess that kind of, well, would have put you in good stead for being nervous in the future if you did that so early on, you know?
I tell you what was the worst was knocking the door before we went to open for Metallica. Was knocking the door. Fucking open the door. It's fucking Lars Ulrich. This is fucking Lars. Like,
that's a magic.
I just couldn't talk. I was just like...
I bet, yeah, if you weren't expecting him to knock on... Was it like your dressing room door or something like that?
Yeah. And he was like, I'll be watching. And I was like, oh, no pressure then, you know?
Nice. Was he nice?
Oh, he's awesome.
Yeah.
A lot of people say bad things about him, but he was a fucking awesome guy.
Yeah, like I'm lucky. I've met him like maybe twice. Once when I was a kid, and once at Glastonbury a couple of years ago, and he just seemed really friendly, nice guy. You know, pleasant. He's not. He doesn't kind of play that kind of rock star role.
No.
That some people do. You know, and they seem unapproachable and. He didn't give off that vibe, yeah.
They all took the time to hang out with us, say hello.
That's amazing.
Drum for the Song podcast.